I'm going to show you today how to create a customized object and pull it into your project library. This is an IO field that we can assign a tag to, and we also have the ability to assign units as well as the name of the tag. So let's get started. So we're going to open Graphics Designer, and first we'll pull out an IO field and we'll configure this the way that we want. I'm not going to assign a tag because we're building a customized object for this. And I'll just click OK, and we'll just kind of use our palette here. So maybe we want to do blue with white font, and then I'll pull up the properties interface for the IO field. I'm going to use Hungarian notation, start with IO tag value as my name. That way I can pick this out of a list. And then under output input, I'm going to default it to just maybe 4 9s and then a 9 and then 1 past the decimal point. And if we want to put a padding character in here, that way we see all 4. And of course we can change any of this. And then now let's get a static text and just kind of put it out here. And I want it to look the same as this, same font, same text and everything. So I'm going to use my copy properties and my paste properties tool to do this. And let's just say that we're going to default this to temperature. So I'll highlight this, go to font. And if I double click in here, notice that my symbol button comes up. And this is how you can pull from your Windows character map. So I am just going to choose the degree symbol. So I'll double click it. It'll pop up in here. And let's say that we're going to do degrees Fahrenheit. So I'll put an F and I'll click OK. And let's say that that's my default text. Now we're going to want to name this default text. So we're going to call this TXT units. And now we're going to make this customized object. So what I'll do is I will select both objects. Make sure only the objects that you want to be part of your customized object are selected. I'm going to right click. We'll do customize object create. And what this is going to do is it's going to give us an interface to build the properties interface here. So these are all your property topics. They give you this kind of user defined one. I am going to rename that and just call it tag assignment. And then under tag assignment, of course, is where we would want to put what tag is going to be associated with this IO field. So this is why we name our objects. I know I only have 2 objects here, but I can pick out my IO tag value. And what you have to know at this point is what property of the IO field do you assign a tag? And that is going to be down to your output value. So I'm going to drag this and drop it under tag assignment, and we'll just leave this output value. But we also want to be able to set the background color, the text of the units, and also the font size. So what I'll do is right click in here, do theme selection, and generally your font size is under font. So I'll put font up there. I'll also put colors up there. And then under font, we want the unit text. So I'm going to select text units and then the text, and I'm going to drag it. I'm going to put it under font. And then I'm going to rename this. I'll do properties, and the property name is going to be units. And the automation name, we're going to leave it as text, and I'll click OK. And then under colors, here's where it gets kind of neat. I'm just going to do text units, and I'll do background color. And I'm going to put it under background color, but I would also want my IO field to be the same color as my units. Now, of course, it doesn't have to be, but let's say that is our preference. Then I'll go to my IO field, and if I drop it under background color, notice that there's one property name, but both of these object background colors are under it. So if I change one, it's going to change them both. So let me show you what we have. I'm going to click OK. And now if you look at our customized object, here is our tag assignment. And I could just go hook a tag directly up to this, and I'll do mixed tank temperature, say OK. And if I go under font, there's my unit. So let's say that we wanted Celsius. Now it's going to pull up this interface, but when I hit the browser button, it's going to give me the character map. Now I don't have to change the degrees. I'm just going to put a C for Celsius just to show you that I can, of course, change that. We'll go to colors, and let's say that we want to do, say, this green for colors. Both of these now change. Now let's say that we wanted to add a few other things to this. Then the procedure would be to right click, go to customize object, edit. And then notice how the handles are white. So I could add another static text, which maybe this is on top and this is going to be the name of this point. And let's say that I wanted to add this in. So I would go in and set this up and just say text tag name. And then I am going to use my eyedroppers to copy and paste. And by default, let's just put in the default text tag name. And when I'm done, this is really important. We are going to lasso all of these, make sure you don't have any other object selected. Right click, customize object, finish editing. Now I can go right click, configuration dialog. It's going to pull my dialog back up. Notice that my tag name is in here. So I might want to put a property to change my tag name. So I'll select text tag name, text, and my cursor is going to go on fonts. So I'm creating a whole different property and I'll do properties. My property name is going to be tag name. And for colors, maybe we'd want the tag name unit to have a different color. So I'll show you how to do that. I have my colors property and I'm going to select my text tag name background color. And notice that my cursor is touching the colors property, not background color, because that would add it to these other three. But if I made a whole different property, then I could change my properties and say, call it tag name label color. Click OK. Now under font, here's my tag name. And we could just put mix tank temperature. We could go check out our color property. Here's our label color. And we can now give it a different color if we want. So I'm gonna add a couple more properties to our object to make it even more usable. So I'm just gonna right click and we can go straight to configuration dialog. For our IO field under font, we want to do the font size. And then we would also want to add the font size of our unit's text under that and also of our tag name. That way, when we change the font size, they're all going to conform to it. Under colors, I will also add a font color. And we will add in the font color for our other units. And just click OK. And then we can just test these out. Change that back to white. That's pretty bad. And then for our font size here, we can change the font size and make it any size that we want. Now we can just drag this into the project library. So I'll go to library and under project library, I'll just click here in the white space, do new folder. I will rename this IO fields. Double click to go in there. Now before I drag this in, I don't really want to have tag connections on this. I mean, you could if you want, but the whole idea is this could be reused. So I'm going to get rid of that tag connection, maybe any scripts that I have. And then under library, I'll choose IO fields. I can drag this right in. I'll right click and rename this to IO field with unit. So now I'm ready to use this. I'll go over to my overview PDL, drag this out on the screen, resize it the way that I want, go to my tag assignment, hook up my tag temperature, save this, and go to runtime. And in runtime, it looks great. I'm using a tag simulator, throw some values in there, but it looks great. You can use this anywhere you want. Obviously, you can do a lot more with this, make very complex objects. I will be creating a follow-up video that goes really in-depth into customized objects. There's a lot that you can do with them. If you got a question answered or you learned something on this video, I'd really appreciate you hitting that like button. Subscribe to my channel. I'm going to be doing a lot in 2024 with WinCC Unified V19 and WinCC. Hey, thanks so much for watching.